Hello one, hello all. This is Vortex Thoughts on the Angry Grandpa Iceberg. I personally created this iceberg. It's available in the link below, and this video is actually a re-upload of my original video, as I have now purchased a better mic for better sound. So we're gonna get this video started, but before I actually get started, I do want to let you guys know to please be mindful that the people that will be mentioned in this video, in this iceberg, are real people. They have lives outside of this, and I do not condone, nor does YouTube's terms and services condone, any harassment or going to go bug, harass, or insult any of the people mentioned in this iceberg at any level. So please be mindful of the fact that Kid Behind the Camera, Michael, Bridget West, Jennifer, Charlie, Kimberly, and everybody in these videos that I can name off the top of my head are real human beings with lives, and it is not up to us to go and harass them on any social media platforms. With that said, let us begin. So first, with the tip of the iceberg. And to start, as we all know, that Kid Behind the Camera and Angry Grandpa first started because of pranks. It began with pranks on Grandpa, which included the Nair hair prank, the heavy metal wake up, you know, stuff like that, along with the ensuing anger and destruction that Angry Grandpa would create as a result of being angry. We can see that with the original 2007 Christmas meltdown, where the Mighty Wallet was the one that, you know, actually gave Christmas, according to Angry Grandpa. So where did Pickle Boy's name come from? So essentially, Pickle Boy's name came from a failed prank, upon which Bridget actually sold him out and told Grandpa, "Hey, Michael's trying to prank you in the shower." And so Grandpa has a jar of pickles, and he throws the pickles on him and starts name calling him. And eventually, that's where Pickle Boy is born from. And it's where that nickname stayed, Pickle Boy. It's to this day, even myself, that's how I refer to Michael, Pickle Boy. Next on here is Pickle Boy is Dirty. And so Pickle Boy being dirty is kind of something that the fans have noticed. He himself, Pickle Boy, has admitted that it's not that he doesn't shower, it's just that he'll actually just wear the same clothes again and look dirty. It's kind of what started the whole Pickle Boy wears a diaper, because they've wondered why he smells so bad, and that's where that kind of whole storyline comes from. Although I guess I place this on the tip, for me, because I happen to know why Michael doesn't drive, and it's a well-known fact that he doesn't drive. What's not as well-known is that Michael doesn't drive due to multiple car accidents that he's either been in or friends of his have been in, and it's basically made him fearful of driving, which is an understandable thing, as his own father almost died due to actually having been in a car accident, along with other things. But AGP's near-death experiences will be way down later in the iceberg, so stay tuned for that. The other big thing about Angry Grandpa is his farts. His farts are legendary. There are multiple compilations that you can find, both in the official Angry Grandpa channel and fan-made compilations, and even in some of the compilation videos where they were making the, where AGP was farting, whether that be Monday mailbags or just regular vlogs that Michael was taking, you can hear him say to Grandpa that he was making the next compilation all on his own. Another big thing about Kid Behind the Camera is that he's a big WWE fan. As you know, the whole family are big fans. If you ever go to things like WrestleMania or house shows in South Carolina, you might just run into them, so keep an eye out. Next is that Michael was a part of Jesse Ridgway's Story Fire, and Michael doesn't upload as much anymore, but you know, Michael is actually recording on there and was supporting Jesse's whole platform, and there's a good chunk of videos on that website that still remain on that website, and they're Story Fire exclusive only content. It's a well-known fact that Michael has been trying to lose weight for a while now. And since about January 13th, I believe, from 2014, you can actually find videos of Michael attempting to lose weight in some capacity. And it's something that to this day in 2022, he is still trying to do. And we here at Vortex Thoughts wish him nothing but good luck on that aspect. Losing weight is hard, and it's something that he's been trying to do, and something that he and you should actually go to listen to him talk about it. He talks about why he has such a hard time losing weight, and it's something that I think can help humanize Michael to the whole kid behind a camera crew. Y'all should go check it out, definitely. To add on to when I mentioned the pranks earlier, another well-known thing is how much destruction Grandpa could give out when he was very upset. One of those being how he destroyed his kitchen not once but twice. One of them being over Walmart pecan wheels, where Angry Grandpa also destroyed a washer. And the tattoo shop, when kid behind the camera, Michael, gave him a very funny tramp stamp. Next, and probably the most contentious issue for a lot of the fans for kid behind the camera, are his use of clickbaity titles and thumbnails. And this is mostly done just to like increase views and increase engagement on his channel. I know it's turned a lot of fans against him and it's made him look bad, but it's something that if you've been watching Kid Behind the Camera and Angry Grandpa long enough, you know that clickbait is gonna come natural to Kid Behind the Camera. In addition to clickbait, there's also this idea about fake pranks. And so the fake pranks are essentially staged pranks. I don't really think that's a bad thing, nor should it be something that they should be shamed for. As we know, when you run a channel like Angry Grandpa or you run a prank channel, it's well known that you can't always prank the people or the person that you're with, whether that be family member or you're outside in public. People recognize you after a while if you do enough pranks and they garner enough attention. And it's just one of those where we kind of, you know, accept the fact that some of it is staged for a reaction, and that's a-okay. To add on to the fake pranks, something that kind of happened directly because of the fake pranks was the blackmailing of the whole Green family. So there was this guy, his name was Dylan. He tried to expose Kid Behind the Camera and Angry Grandpa as fake. And if you watch the condom prank where they fill up the condoms with water and then drop them on their head, he actually shows up in that video, and a lot of people were wondering at the time, who is this guy? Well, that guy was somebody who kind of lived close to them and threatened to make to release information that they were fake. And then Michael ended up going to Keemstar on Drama Alert and, you know, came clean and told them, hey, this is what happened. We're not okay with this. Next on the list is drama with family and friends, primarily with Doug, Tina, and Charlie. So I'm sure it's been seen in the recent vlogs on Kid Behind the Camera how they've been having issues with both Charlie, with Doug, and with Tina. Tina being the most recent, I believe. And a lot of this stems from a lot of different things, but it's just drama that's been happening because their family feels entitled in a specific way to their channel. And I will eventually, on the actual Iceberg, go through the rest of the issues. But one of the big things is just that they, Doug, Tina, and Charlie, along with the other few couple people, went out of their way to ensure that they could throw as much dirt as they could on Angry Grandpa and on Michael and Bridget. And lastly, on this part of the Iceberg, is Michael's friendship with Boogie2998 and McJuggernuggets. It's a well-known fact, or maybe not as well-known, that both Boogie and McJuggernuggets were heavily inspired by Angry Grandpa. Michael is not kidding when he says Grandpa was the original Rage Tuber. The original Christmas video was the one that had Michael and Grandpa go viral, both on YouTube and Break.com. Now moving on to the middle of the iceberg. So in the middle of the iceberg, we have side channels. And this one's not that well known, but it's kind of well known that Michael created a lot of side channels. He has one right now where he's going to apparently at some point upload more personable videos about himself that he would not put on Kid Behind the Camera, which is the vlog channel. There's the fact that Angry Grandpa had two channels at one point, and I believe I will eventually get to that. But I know that originally his video, he created these channels as a failsafe.
What's going on, you guys? Kid Behind the Camera here.
Bridget. Next, one of the things that I found funny at the time, because I myself was watching this, was the No Bridget intros. And so in recent times, Bridget has become one of the fan favorites, and she's one of the faces that everybody can't wait to see. But back in the day, when the daily vlogging was a thing on Kid Behind the Camera, Michael would go out of his way to attempt to have a No Bridget intro. And it was one of those things where he'd try his best to have No Bridget, and then Bridget would somehow sneak right in. It was a very entertaining little bit they had going on, and it was one of my favorite things to see. Next on here is hitting and terrifying his nephews. So Michael has been known that to delete older videos, and that's for a reason. In some of the older videos, you can see him kind of terrorizing his nephews when they were really little. It's something that if you want to get into, I highly recommend looking at other videos like Primink and other channels. They go into more detail about it, more than I could on an iceberg, but it's just one of those things where Michael would scare his own nephews. Another kind of well-known fact, but one that Michael doesn't really talk about anymore, is his attempt to have a commercially successful rap career. He would go by the pseudonym Lyricold, and he felt that I want to be just like Eminem. Both myself and Eminem come from these dysfunctional families living in trailer homes, and I think I can help create and change the way people think about us. His music never really garnered any mainstream success, but it's something that, you know, exists out there. And if you look up Lyricold, Lyricold on YouTube, you can and will find Michael's older raps and one that he actually wrote about his own dad, which has been playing in the background of this video. Something else that's kind of mentioned, that's brought up and teased about on vlogs and on Twitter, is Bridget creating an OnlyFans account. And a lot of this centers around them joking around that they have no money. Whether that's true or not, we have yet to see, but that is something that they joke about off and on, about creating and, you know, continuing an OnlyFans account. So keep an eye out for that, I guess. Something that's kind of known, but it's not really talked about anymore, but it used to be a big thing, was that Michael had been collecting toy WWE superstars. It had been a joke where AGP would come in and tell him, you can't play with toys, or Bridget would sneak record him playing with the toys. And it's something that in older vlogs, with when Grandpa was still with us, where you could see Michael, you know, buying wrestlers, and AGP being very upset about the fact that Michael had wrestlers. Next, something that's kind of cool is that Michael and Grandpa and a lot of them ended up on TV due to the Rage videos that they put on YouTube. There's the Senior SmackDown one. There is Discovery, where the Discovery in the UK came in and, you know, wanted to interview them over their videos, and whether or not the content was staged, whether he actually got that angry. Michael talks about it in some vlogs. Y'all should go watch him, because I definitely don't do this story justice. Next on here, and probably the biggest thing that Michael does get some commentaries on, is meeting Bridget. So you ask yourself, how did Michael and Bridget meet? Well, they met on MySpace. Bridget really liked the picture, and at the time, Michael said sure. They went on dates, and they've been inseparable ever since. The issue arises in the fact that Michael states that Bridget lied to him and told him that she told him that she was only 19, when it turned out that she was about 16 when they actually met, and Michael was 21 at the time. One of the cooler things that exists on Grandpa's Corner and Grandpa's channel are Angry Grandpa's Trailer Park Cooking. And essentially, this is just recipes that Grandpa would put on YouTube for families to follow and look into. And the recipes are pretty good. If y'all ever want to see what AGP cooked like, I really recommend looking into these videos and following these recipes in order to make your own trailer park lasagna, hamburgers, whatever you can find that Angry Grandpa made. This part of the iceberg is dedicated to the fact that on multiple occasions, both Michael and Bridget have been arrested. So has Jennifer. So has Charlie, obviously. And at one point, so was Grandpa. A lot of it is just from what they tell us, and there's no specific like rap sheet they all have. It was, according to them, all due to misunderstandings that happened, you know, due to arguments or whatever. If you want more information on who and why was arrested, check out their channel. Some of the screenshots are provided, and if you Google Bridget West arrested, you'll literally see it right on Kid Behind the Camera's channel. So it goes without saying that Angry Grandpa, before he passed, had been married and divorced not once but twice. I'll go into his first divorce only briefly because we don't really know that much, and both his ex-wife and any children from that marriage deserve their privacy, as they have not made themselves public figures for the most part. He did have one daughter, and I will talk about her later on in the video. But aside from his first wife, he married Tina, who he had Charlie, Jennifer, Kimberly, and then Michael with Tina. And eventually they got divorced at one point in the beginning of the channels, and it's something that if you go back enough, you can find them actually talking about it, well, Grandpa specifically. And I guess talking about, you know, Angry Grandpa's love life is Lauren. Who is Lauren? Why was Lauren even in the videos? How did she meet Grandpa? So Lauren actually has a whole video on her own YouTube channel, which I recommend watching, as you know, she talks about it in better detail than I ever could on an iceberg. But essentially, Lauren really liked Grandpa. She liked the channel, she liked the content he produced. She eventually became a Twitch mod, and through that connection, they started talking to each other and realized they had a lot in common. And that's where it kind of started, and where they started dating. Now, moving on to the bottom of the iceberg. Is AGP racist? So, if you go far back enough in some of the videos, you can find instances of Grandpa saying things like, or wearing things that kind of hinted towards racism. I personally do not think that Angry Grandpa was racist. It's just, he would say a lot of things. He'd say a lot of things about Mexicans, imply that people who wouldn't let him pay his bills voted for Obama, and that he would essentially be border patrol in his own town. And there's a whole series called Ice Patrol, I believe, on Grandpa's Corner. So something that isn't as well known is Charlie, Michael's oldest brother, only other brother, is an abuser. So part of the reason that Michael has had so much drama with Charlie is due to the fact that Charlie is unpredictable, violent, and an active addict. We're not here to insult Charlie for his addictions. That is something that is a disease, and I am not an expert in that, and nor will I pass any judgments on that. But what is known about, you know, Charlie, and because he is an addict, is that he's hit people like Bridget. He tried to drug and get his nephews drunk and give them drugs and force them to take the drugs. He allegedly would hit Grandpa to the point where Grandpa was actually afraid to come out of his own room in his own home. And as we know, the reason that Charlie got kicked out of Michael's house was due to the fact that he not only hit Bridget, but he also destroyed their pool house and hurt himself. And it was while he was allegedly high on LSD. These videos exist on the internet. There's a lot of expose videos on Charlie. I highly recommend that you watch them, as well as the allegations that Charlie did sexually assault his own two sisters when they were younger with a friend. I will not get into any more details other than that. If you can handle that kind of content, I highly recommend you look into it yourself. It's one of those things where I can't believe this actually happened, but it really did. And it exists on the interwebs, and I recommend you watch it on the internet. Hand in hand with the abuse that Charlie Wood put out to both his sisters and to some of the other boys is the allegations of childhood trauma, both for Michael and his siblings growing up, and some that allegedly happened to the boys. And so it's been implied that because the Green family was so poverty stricken while growing up, that there was some abuse that would happen. Angry Grandpa didn't have access to reliable access to medications, and as a result, when he would fly off the wall, he would fly off the wall very violently. And apparently he kind of calmed down once Michael was born. And Jenny talks about some stories about the heat vent, which I think you guys should go look at Jenny talk about it. And then there's the cheese story, which is another good one that you guys should hear Michael talk about it. And it's just essentially that they would get hit, and you know, over things that maybe in his older age, Grandpa really wouldn't have done. Next on here is corporal punishment. As mentioned earlier, right before this entry, Michael, Jennifer, and Charlie and Kimberly would talk about how Grandpa would hit them, or you know, throw things at them. It's something that you could see in the earlier videos, like the 2007 Christmas episode or Meltdown, I mean. And it's just one of those things that exists on the internet. If you really want to get into it, it's right there. It's out in the open. Next up on here, and something that I think we can all celebrate Jenny for, is Jenny has been able to get clean and stay sober in the last couple years. If you watch her in the older videos, you can see her kind of seem out of it, always wear sunglasses, and while never addressed even at the time or even now, which is fine, we're not entitled to that information. It's been addressed maybe once. It was implied that Jennifer at the time was actively doing drugs and drinking, I believe, in an excessive amount. And to know that she has stayed clean and, you know, been able to better her life and, you know, regain custody of her children is something that I think we can all agree is amazing, and we're happy for her. Great job, Jenny. We're all proud of you. I mentioned it earlier, but essentially, you know, the other part of this thing with Charlie is that he uses drugs. He tried to give drugs to his nephews, and you know, he used LSD and tripped out and destroyed Pickle Boy's pool house. And that's pretty much it. I talked about it already, but I won't get into too many details after that. So something that's kind of funny, kind of not, is, and I'll get into Grandpa's flea market endeavors later on in the actual video, is Grandpa used to sell a lot of adult materials at a flea market, and it started this rumor around Charleston, I believe, where the flea market was, that he would make, you know, the smex porn with his children. Once that rumor started going around, Grandpa actually stopped selling it and, you know, decided to just sell everything that was rated E for everyone. Something kind of fun is how Grandpa, while at the flea market, who he had a whole restaurant, which we'll talk about later on, he would actually cook for a group of bikers. And as a result of Grandpa cooking them good food, the bikers essentially really liked it and made him an honorary member. Another thing that not a lot of people know as to why Grandpa had to leave Trailwood originally, then go to Creekside Community, where he met Tina, the neighbor, and also where Cindy lives, is that Boeing, like the airplane company, actually tried and successfully bought the land that Trailwood was on. Angry Grandpa really did try his best to save that community. He would walk door to door. He would get his fans to call into City Hall. He would talk to the neighbors and try to get people to go to local local meetings. And he really did try to, you know, collectively unite the community in order to not allow Boeing to buy the land. But eventually the land was sold and it became a parking lot. Something that may warrant going up the iceberg, but at the time of creating this iceberg was not that well known, was the Bridget West Reddit thread. And there's a group of, like, I'd say 1,000 men, it seems like, based on the Reddit thread alone, that have been posting screenshots of Bridget's body, mostly just butt shots, and fan fiction about Bridget, her leaving Michael. It's like a whole thing. If you go to Reddit, look up the Bridget West Reddit thread. It's even alleged that Michael posts on there. So if you guys want to go see some things, there's the Reddit thread. Next on here is Michael's friendship with Daddy05. It's something that they don't talk about anymore, but if you look far enough in their channel, you can actually find videos where Daddy05 and the whole family was visiting Michael in South Carolina, and they were good friends. I remember specifically that Michael actually did try to defend Daddy05 before a lot of the evidence came against them, and then when the evidence came against them, Michael hasn't really talked about them all that much. But these videos are still on Michael's channel up to this day. This one was made more for fun because I thought it was a little bit funny when watching one of Michael's more recent vlogs, is that Michael and Bridget leave their kids in the car when they go shopping. I don't really think this is true. As Michael, Bridget, and Jennifer had gone to a store to buy some meat, and they were like, they had to call 911 because the door got locked and the kids got stuck in there. I don't really think that Bridget went away from her kids. I know she, as a mother, really loves her children. This one's just a haha kind of funny thing. So please don't go harass Bridget or Michael about this. I do not believe this one bit. And let's just be mindful that, you know, they are, you know, actual human beings. So, like father, like son, even Michael has had to deal with Boeing. So Michael's first original apartment with Bridget, he had to move out of it because I believe Boeing wanted to purchase some land there or around there. Michael's second house that they lived in, also the land near it got taken, bought up by Boeing, and they had to leave that area. And the house that they're in now is the house that they went to after the second house, I believe, got bought up by Boeing. So on more than one occasion, Michael's had to deal with Boeing trying to kick him out of the places he lived. And so it goes without saying that many prank channels, they have in some capacity had to delete videos, whether they be not cool for YouTube nowadays, whether they garnered a lot of heat recently. It just goes without saying, and Angry Grandpa channel is one of those. I know Michael talks about a fake bomb prank that actually got the FBI involved. And just pranks that if Michael were to have tried to replicate in today's day and nature, it really wouldn't fly. If you ever want to check out some of those videos, look them up on YouTube, like AGP deleted pranks. They're out there and they're kind of really funny. And so one of the deleted pranks, which I think garnered its own section on this iceberg, or I guess an explanation of it, is Michael did a prank, a really gross one, where he peed, spit, and threw loogies into this chili that AGP was cooking for the family. It's pretty gross. If you're kind of grossed out by that, don't watch this part of the video. You can listen to it, like look away. But essentially he just did that, mixed it in, and then had his family try it, and they thought I don't know what's wrong with this. This tastes kind of weird, and never told him what it, that it was a prank where, you know, he did all of that, and it's pretty gross. Shame on you for that one, Michael. And so the last thing on here will be Charlie once again. And Charlie, as we all know, got kicked out of Michael's house. Michael, for a while, was paying for his motel / hotel stay. Like, you know, didn't want to leave him out in the street. But eventually, Charlie did what Charlie does best, and he alienated the last person that was willing to deal with him. And so, in doing that, Michael actually decided enough was enough and stopped paying for his motel stay. And so Charlie was left with no resources. He went to his half-sister, who will be mentioned later on in this video. And eventually, he just was not having it. And he went to the friend's house, I believe. And then when he was at his friend's house, he essentially slept with his friend's wife to go to show, you know, what kind of a person Charlie really is. His friend opened up his home to him, and that's what Charlie did as a thank you gift. So the next part that I want to go over are the ghosts that have been present in Anchor Grandpa's whole YouTube channel. So the first one is AGP has a trash can ghost. That's like the nicest way of phrasing it, but essentially, Grandpa had a video on Grandpa's Corner where they didn't notice it at the time, but not until fans started watching it, they saw a little head pop out on the trash can as Grandpa looked over to these firefighters on this fire truck that were like driving through. I really recommend you go check it out. It's one of those freaky videos. They attested to none of the boys being outside at the time of that whole thing. Do as you think and do some research, but it's a pretty freaky one. So going on about Grandpa and like the ghost stories, is he has a couple on his channel. He has one called The Man in a Suit, and so it's a bit of a convoluted story. I really recommend watching Grandpa talk about it, because Grandpa does a really good job, clearly, of telling the story. But essentially, Grandpa's grandpa died. And at the time they would present people in their own homes, and this was actually the trailer from Trailwood. And Grandpa was maybe about 8 years old, and he essentially was playing, you know, doing his thing, and this man shows up, and this man is like, hey little guy, my hat fell, do you think you can help me? So Grandpa goes and helps him get the hat from under the house. The old man then gives him the silver dollar. The silver dollar was something that his dad noticed, Grandpa's dad noticed, and was like, where'd you get that dollar from? And he's like, the man in the nice suit gave it to me. Grandma then pulls out a picture book, says, do you see the man who gave you the silver dollar? I don't know why I said it like that. Did you see the man that gave you the silver dollar? And Grandpa says, yeah, it's that guy. And it turns out it was one of the grandfather's friends who passed away before grandpa's grandpa passed away. I recommend you go watch it. Grandpa tells the story like no other, no exaggeration. The next one, and the final part of this part of the iceberg, is the Somerville Light. This one is a little bit of a tale and a little bit of something that actually happened to Grandpa. Essentially, Grandpa tells the story of how he and his friends went out to these train tracks in the middle of nowhere in the 60s, and they saw this light hanging around, and it came up above them. It shocked them because it turned off the car. It even scared the dog that was with them. And essentially, that light is allegedly the light of this woman whose husband was a train conductor, and she would meet him at that train station every day to, like, you know, walk him home in the dark. And one day she showed up, and the guy, he got off the train wrong, and the train actually, you know, took his head off. And, you know, she's been looking for his head ever since. And that's what the Somerville Light is. You should go, like I said in the earlier one, go watch Grandpa's story telling aspects of this, because it's so much better from Grandpa. Now moving on to the deep waters. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is why Doug had so much drama with Bridget and Michael towards the end of him being on that channel. And a lot of it actually stems from the fact that Doug had it in his head, allegedly, that if Grandpa were to pass away, he would become the new Angry Grandpa and thus become entitled to whatever monetary compensation came from that. Michael felt otherwise, and I'm sure the fans would have felt otherwise. And as a result, Doug felt that he was wrong somehow, and that's what really started that whole drama. Yeah. And so something that's not that well known is that back in like 2008-2009, Angry Grandpa's first original channel was actually banned off of YouTube, which is crazy if you think about it. But yeah, his original video was deleted due to violations of terms and services at the time. I don't really know, nor could I find a reason as to why this channel was deleted, nor any like indications that this channel was deleted. But there was a deleted channel. I remember seeing that deleted channel myself personally. So if you guys know anything about it, leave it in the comments down below. So the next part of this whole thing, and kind of what led to Grandpa being on Discovery UK, as mentioned earlier in the Iceberg, was the AGP toenail videos. And so essentially the toenail videos are Grandpa would get these horrendous ingrown toenails that would curve into his skin and poke out the other side, and he with pliers would essentially do surgery himself and rip them off. It's really gross, and I recommend you don't watch it. Michael did a video where he talks about AGP's ingrown toenails and gives a demonstration without the grossness. So if you want to know more about that, I really recommend it. And these were both uploaded, these videos are all uploaded to both YouTube and Break.com, and that's what got them, as I said, on Discovery in the UK, because it was like crazy American surgeries, since, you know, Americans don't have universal healthcare in this country. So the next thing is AGP's sex videos. And so essentially these are just Michael would either try to prank Grandpa and set himself up and then saw too much, or walked in on Grandpa and his mom Tina doing the devil's tango. Michael just literally recorded it and then put it up on YouTube on Break.com, and that's pretty much all there is to it. Like, Michael just happened to walk in and then recorded it and put it up on YouTube like a weirdo. Like, I personally think that's a little sus, Michael, but we're not gonna give him too much of a hard time, because it must have been it was kind of funny thinking about it, watching it back in the day. One of my personal favorite stories from Grandpa, and it goes to show, you know, that Grandpa wasn't ashamed of, you know, not being the toughest guy all around, is his I got beat up by a gay guy story. I really, 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 I cannot emphasize how much you guys need to go watch this video yourselves. But essentially, Grandpa tells a story how in the 60s, he and his friends try to mug a gay dude because they were like, hey, this guy's gay, he's not gonna fight us. And the gay guy not only stood up for himself, but beat him and all his friends up, took all their money, and then took their car out of the woods. It's the main reason why Grandpa's not a fan of bullying, funny enough. And I cannot emphasize how much you guys need to go watch this video, because the first time I watched this video, I could not hold my laughter. As mentioned earlier in the video, I said, hey, Grandpa had another kid with his first wife. And Grandpa's oldest daughter, Miss Dawn Michelle, there's not really much known about her, and I think we need to respect what we do know, and, you know, respect what we do know, and leave her be. She only really came out once Charlie had left Michael's house and was crashing at people's places. Apparently Michael and his family don't really talk to her. We don't really know much about her, and I think we need to respect that, so let's not harass her. But yeah, Don Michelle's grandpa's first child from his first marriage. And so another good grandpa story from Grandpa's Corner is Grandpa Goes to Woodstock. Something that's not that well known is Grandpa used to be a really big stoner. And as a result of him being a stoner, he actually, you know, was a hardcore hippie back in the 60s, and he got on a bus and drove it all the way to Woodstock. They found some honeys, they had some fun, and they smoked some weed. Go watch it. It's definitely worth experiencing that with Grandpa. So something that kind of explains why Kid Behind the Camera and the whole Green family were such huge fans of WWE is that Michael could not and did not like the whole like retail work. And his first serious job that would be considered work from home was working for Paul Heyman. He apparently worked on website stuff and like web development. I'm not entirely sure. Michael just kind of briefly talks about it, but you can actually find vlogs where Michael shows up in Paul Heyman's videos. And you know, when they needed money, Paul Heyman was the first one they went to, and Paul Heyman was the first one to actually help them. So, fun fact, Grandpa was a Heyman guy because Paul Heyman was a genuinely amazing person. There's not much else to say, and I'll leave it at that. So, something that was kind of talked about was, and what kind of started the whole drama with Tina, was the rumor that Tina would sell Grandpa painkillers, and that's the real reason why Grandpa and Tina and Kid Behind the Camera had such a large falling out, and Tina started trying to throw dirt on their name, was that Michael forbade, you know, the purchasing of said substances. And as a result, Tina was very upset about it. I don't know how true or factual this is. It's a heavy allegation to put on anyone to either purchase or to sell. And this is all just a rumor. There is no fact proof of it. Please do not go imply such things to either Tina, Michael, or Bridget, or anybody in the Green family. It's like I said, it's just a rumor. I don't know how true it is. It's just something that I thought would be worth mentioning in this video because it is one of those things that, you know, they talked about. So I kind of briefly mentioned it earlier in the video, but Charlie did allegedly abuse AGP. It's one of those things, and it's the original reason why Charlie ended up moving into the pool house before we knew the extent of the abuse that Charlie did, i.e. giving his nephew drugs, you know, doing LSD and hitting Bridget and destroying things. It wasn't really talked about why, it's just that there were issues, and apparently, allegedly, those issues were that Charlie would hit AGP. Really quickly, I realized in the original video, I didn't talk about it, but it's in the iceberg, is that AGP had a stoma. If you don't know what a stoma is, it's basically a hole in the throat, and this hole allows breathing and such. It happens to habitual smokers, something that we know AGP was, and essentially when Michael was about 10 or so, I might be wrong on the age, Grandpa had a stoma, and he just took the little device out or something and it closed up eventually, and then he just didn't have a stoma anymore. And so something that isn't nearly as well known, because Charlie isn't talked about as often on this channel, is the time that he went to jail. And so Charlie went to jail not because he hit anybody or anything, but simply because he missed child support payments, and so it was part of his probation or something. He actually shows up on the news where they were talking about it, and it's like one of the pranks that they did to Grandpa, where Charlie broke out of prison or broke out of jail. And if you find, you go looking in some of the older vlogs, you'll actually find videos of Charlie, like, you know, on the news in Charleston. Fun fact. So the time has arrived for me to talk about the AGP flea market. And so essentially, the flea market was where Grandpa and Michael, because Michael would be the one that primarily went with Grandpa, would go and sell little trinkets, and eventually Grandpa got the idea of starting a little restaurant there. And so the restaurant actually went really well. They would get a lot of orders. They would be very busy. There's a lot of stories involved around the flea market. My favorite one being the time that they had a large, you know, business business catering where Michael spilled a bunch of spaghetti dinner, and Grandpa was super pissed the entire time. But it went really well and eventually was shut down due to outside factors in which Grandpa allegedly got ripped off from the restaurant. But, you know, as much as Michael would kid around and give Grandpa a hard time, Grandpa's actually a really, really good cook. So the second to last thing on this iceberg is AGP had several near-death experiences. Angry Grandpa talks about it a lot. He had some on an operating table when he got his first gastric bypass surgery at a car accident. And Grandpa just talks about how, you know, he had a couple near-death experiences where he either died on the operating table or en route to said thing. And, you know, he slipped into a coma. It's something that they talk about on the channel sometimes. And it's like one of the things that Michael brought up at his funeral, where they thought, hey, he's gonna pull through this one. He pulled through a bunch of different ones before. And even Grandpa himself talks about it. If you guys want to check it out, check it out. Grandpa's Corner and Kid Behind the Camera. Just it's there. And so my favorite, absolute favorite story, and goes to show, you know, how long of a life Grandpa lived, was that Grandpa was friends with a serial killer. Not just any serial killer, he was friends with Donald Pee-wee Gaskins. If you don't know who Donald Pee-wee Gaskins is, that's okay. This man was a serial killer in the 60s. And, you know, we don't really like to talk about those people. There's a lot of good videos out there, some by Bailey Sarian, and other, like, reputable sources that have talked about him. Highly recommended if you don't know who he is. But essentially, Grandpa just talks about how he and this dude were friends. And one time Grandpa was a little roughhoused with him and hit him. And he told Grandpa that if they weren't such good friends, he'd end up in Pee-wee's cemetery. And it wasn't no joke. I think it's interesting to see, like, the kind of life that he lived. And, you know, that, hey, like, this man lived an interesting life to the end. And so concludes the re-upload of the Angry Grandpa Iceberg video. If you like this video, please like, comment, and subscribe. If you think I forgot some things, put them down in the comments below. Once again, these are all people who, you know, are part of the Angry Grandpa lore, so to speak, for lack of a better word. So let's not go harass them in any way. We do not condone that here on this channel or on YouTube. It's just, here's a video of the history of Grandpa, something that I've been wanting to see created, so I went and created it myself. Hope you guys liked it, and stay tuned for more. If you guys have any, you know, any video ideas or anything that you'd like to see done by me, go ahead and put them down in the comments. It's something that I'm open, if it sounds interesting, I'm willing and open to do it. I just personally really wanted to create an iceberg, and I hope you guys liked it. So, have a good one. See you guys next time.